Bentley, 40 years, take one.
Now hold it up in front of your face.
Okay? Let me say take one or take two.
Take one.
People ask me, you know, what do you do? I work for a software company. You never heard of us, Bentley Systems. But when all of our users gather together, they're all familiar with what we do, who we are. Software is a people business. Engineers are our users. They have an ongoing relationship with their tools. We would describe ourselves as the infrastructure engineering software company.
If something is large enough that it sits at a fixed location on the earth and doesn't move, then we call that infrastructure. Buildings, plants, highways, roadways.
I don't think there's anyone now for whom infrastructure is invisible. It's not invisible when it's not working, and it's not invisible when we have to make decisions about it, and we do in the world at large. What is clear is that going digital for infrastructure is the solution to challenges and opportunities in the world. And we're the company that's most comprehensively in leadership of doing that.
Electronic computers are being used extensively by science and industry.
When I was in junior high school, the world of computers was brand new. There was one at our school, and if you signed up, you could get an hour on the computer. I did that every hour I could, and I found that it was just amazing that you could type things into this computer and cause something to come back out.
Didn't have any screens or anything in those days. You had to write the program, and you'd say, save to paper tape, and it would punch out a paper tape.
Made programs that, you know, did math problems.
And I wrote a program that played blackjack. And that was my first experience with computers.
Our mother was a school teacher and very creative person, and throughout childhood, it seems, we were always doing things that were a little bit out of the realm and the norm. If everyone else would have a book cover that looked a certain way, we made ours from scratch in a different way. There was always paper mache, and there was no end of different ways to try things and learn things.
I very much learned from my father about when you took something apart, fixed whatever was wrong, put it back together, and then the problem was solved.
My father was a true handyman. He could build everything, he could fix anything. I think that's where a lot of it came from.
When I was 15, he said, you can have a vehicle, we can use it here. And he said, it has to be a pickup truck, and you can only pay $25 for it. And we did find a truck worth $25, and millions of dollars worth of labor went into making it a viable vehicle, including by all the brothers. We worked on it together.
I think that led me to think about a career in engineering. I was hired by the DuPont company, where my father had worked his entire career. They said, well, we have this opening in our group called the CAD group. And I said, that sounds great. What does it stand for? CAD at the time meant computer-aided drafting. There were rooms of drafting boards, and people bent over drafting boards, and you could watch them do it, and they were artists. Pencils, erasers, straight edges. I remember the first time I saw a real draftsman look at a computer screen and be able to just change a mistake, move it from here to there, because that was, you would have had to erase the whole thing. So I started working on computer-aided drafting at DuPont. It was the most fun you could have and get paid for it. The idea was there was one computer that was shared by a dozen or so people. So I literally had to come to work at 3 a.m. so that I could get on the computer. And I thought, well, there has to be a better way. So I wrote some software so I could use a small terminal on my desk during the day. So it was mostly laziness, I would say, that led to the first program that became ultimately PseudoStation and Bentley Systems.
Two other graduate students and I started a company called Dynamic Solutions, and the product was for collecting data from chemistry instruments and analyzing it. I said, hey, Keith, you want to come out and work for us? And I was surprised when he said, I'll think about it.
I thought it was kind of cool. My mother was distraught. She thought it was the dumbest idea ever. She did not understand how you could make money. It's software, something you couldn't even see.
Basically, she thought Keith was crazy.
I decided to quit my job at DuPont and move to California and work for Barry and his company. At the time, I didn't know if I was leaving the greatest job for the dumbest idea ever, and turned out a little bit of both. So I began working for Dynamic Solutions, Barry's company. You know, interesting programming challenge, but we never made a nickel. It was very difficult. So I told Barry, I said, look, chemistry ain't the way for us to, you know, make a living. This CAD thing is a bigger opportunity. I've seen it from the other side. Let's see if we could start marketing the software that I had written for DuPont. We started Bentley Systems. I sold half of Bentley Systems to Barry. He gave me half of his shares in Dynamic Solutions at the time, so we were both 50-50 owners of both of the companies. Our first product, PseudoStation, ran on a VAX, which was a probably $1 million computer on average, so it was very expensive to buy the hardware, and our software made the VAX a little bit more productive, but basically it merely solved the same problem that you could solve on a drafting board. Bentley Systems started doing well from the very beginning. We sold more CAD software than chemistry software from the first month.
We decided to move back to Philadelphia. We ended up in Philadelphia.
We kind of decided that, hey, let's try to recruit people we know.
And when we decided we were going to move, what we did was we called Scotty. One attribute of Scott is the kind of guy who gets things done. I mean, he goes out and finds people. He goes out and makes the deals with people. And then we hired Raymond.
And they called me up and said, hey, you want to work with us at a company? And I thought, that'll be a blast. So they gave me a project,
a piece of hardware to work on, and expecting him to take a few weeks and call us back and say how it went. The next day he called back, I got it working.
Barry used to say, Ray spends 95% of his time programming and 5% thinking. So I kind of throw stuff together. Being able to come back and to work with Keith and Barry was a dream come true for me.
We were selling PseudoStation, and we were starting to develop something called MicroStation, which was the ability to run separate from the Intergraph VAC system, a standalone computer-aided design on PCs.
The personal computer had started to become available, and I said, that's where we should be working.
Things were moving extremely quickly, and we were solving problems that were right at the state of the art of computer graphics, and they were brand new and doing things that no one had ever seen before.
You know, we were pretty loosey-goosey back then, that's for sure. I mean, we didn't have like a, you know, firm business plan or anything like that. We realized that we needed more drive, you know, and Greg was the supplier of drive for sure.
We weren't sure we wanted to work for Greg, because we knew when Greg showed up, we'd end up working for Greg.
I may have just showed up. I'm not sure. It wasn't a matter of negotiating or hiring. I was just inclined to help, and I decided I would rather have brothers than partners or be in a corporate environment.
Greg started applying what I think he now calls financial engineering, because yeah, it's cool to be an engineer at Bentley Systems. At the end of the week, he knew more about all of our users, what they do, how they made money, how they used our software than practically anybody else at Bentley Systems.
And it fell to me to decide that we should go from being entirely indirect in our commercial model to being almost entirely direct. And we heard lots of advice to broaden horizontally, but I have always thought we should set our compass by that which would be of greatest value to professionals accomplishing something important.
What we quickly learned was the way to determine how well a product works for its intended problem is to talk to the people who are actually using it.
We started having the support engineer of the day, and the idea was the other bunch of guys would be able to concentrate on development, and this guy would take all those support calls.
MicroStation was a brand new product. People would call us and they'd say, hey, this is great, but could it do this, you know, or this doesn't work.
The word customer was always jarring to me. It implied a transaction, which describes some of the economy, but doesn't describe people's relationship to their software tools, especially engineers. I liked to say user because it implied an ongoing relationship. We're casting ourselves alongside rather than across from.
When you pick a problem to work on, a software problem to work on, there's many choices that you can make. But we kind of decided that we would prefer to pick harder problems, bigger projects, longer term projects.
The growth of the company really started when we moved to Gordon Drive, up to Exton. We started acquiring companies that were in kind of a similar space.
Something I certainly remember learning is the talent and resources of our colleagues overseas. The bulk of our business is outside the U.S. Bulk of our colleagues are outside the U.S. to discover how much opportunity there is, how much talent there is.
The wide variety of stuff that our program is used for is what really impresses me. We can't take any credit for it all. I mean, we just provide the tools and people have the creativity to use it.
It was gratifying that we could see we put the tools in the hands and what real artists can do with those, real engineers can do with those tools.
I sometimes say, look, I wish I was 30 years younger because it's a great time. My Bentley Systems future is amazing.
The digital twin opportunity is as exciting as anything could be.
The idea of a digital twin, it's so liberating to me from a software perspective. Like, oh, we're now not constrained by the old paradigms. If the digital model represents the real thing, engineers get better insights on how to make it work better, how past decisions affected, you know, its performance. And all those things are, you know, great business opportunities for software companies.
Ultimately, digital twins allow you to maintain infrastructure, spending less and having a more effective and safer infrastructure asset that will continue to live beyond its intended time frame. AI makes it even compound faster. And those are the times we're in as we're handing over the reins. It's to a young leadership group who are, I think, as excited about that as we were along these 40 years at Bentley Systems. We're investing for the future. You want people with you who are going to be likewise making decisions to benefit the future.
Infrastructure is something that every human relies on, and resilient infrastructure is really important. And software for making existing infrastructure more resilient and for creating new infrastructure that will work better, last longer. Those are the kinds of things that, you know, when you think about what your job is, if you're helping with that, I think you can feel pretty good about it. I do.
I've always been very proud of our company. The type of stuff we do is the kind of thing that improves people's lives.
And it does make the world a better place. The world needs better infrastructure, all the more so now.
A limit on our quality of life is the quality of our infrastructure. And that depends on infrastructure engineering. Their work depends on the software tools that they have. That depends on us at Bentley Systems.